have an idea in your mind of something you want, and you deserve to get it. So how do you get there? Well, welcome to the Idea Space, a podcast devoted to helping you overcome frustration and make what you want a reality. I'm your host, Jen Liddy, high school teacher turned entrepreneur. Now I'm a business development coach. It's my mission to help women bring their ideas to life and get what they want without feeling guilty, selfish, overwhelmed, or lost. Every week, I share topics, tools, and strategies to help you move toward that thing you want. Create time and energy to do the things you love, get clarity on what you really want and how to get there, and most importantly, stop feeling alone with your challenges. Whether you've wanted to create a better business, job, relationship, hobby, or self, I know there's something more that you want, and it's time you were able to get it with confidence and clarity. Ready to have it? Let's go. Hey, welcome back to the Idea Space. I'm your host, Jen Liddy. And on this podcast today, I'm continuing the theme of what's valuable, what's worth it, and how do we know the difference? So last week, I talked to you about the paradigm of giving great free content away to create a ton of value in the world for your audience before they pay you a dime. You know, basically, it's helping people to prove that you can help people. And I was answering the question, why do you give so much away for free, that I get sometimes from potential clients, sometimes from clients who have already decided to work with me. They're like, how come you give so much away? Like you help out people so much and you don't get paid. And I won't reiterate everything I said, but the short answer to that question is, why do I give so much away for free? Because that's how the marketplace works these days. And I want you to remember that people don't pay for information, they pay for transformation. But at the beginning of my entrepreneurial journey, I didn't understand this concept fully. I was suspect of people giving away their stuff, and I kept waiting for the other shoe to drop. And so I want you to remember that in my first business, I really had no idea what I was doing. I was a teacher who had made this gigantic leap. My husband has been in business his whole life and is a business coach, and I completely ignored every single thing he told me. And so I didn't understand that this paradigm of information versus transformation was a thing. So all I knew about myself was that I was smart and resourceful and hardworking. Now, remember that I told you 90% of the people do nothing with the information they consume. Like they consume and they consume and they consume, but they don't do anything with it. Like it lives on their computer forever. And only 10% of the people consume and then implement. Well, the good news for me is I'm one of those 10% of people. I can take something I hear or read or learn and pretty much put it into action right away. But because I didn't realize the whole journey in my first business, I took every free resource available to me and used the shit out of it. So if there was a webinar on marketing or sales or copywriting, I carved out I didn't have a lot of time. So I carved out time to be there and engaged fully. And that's like a way that we pay. We pay for things with our time, our energy, or our money. And all of this free stuff was awesome. And it was incredibly valuable to me. And I bet you've had the same experience where something is free and really awesome and really helpful. And if you're like me, especially the way I was at the beginning of my entrepreneurial journey, I was a complete sponge. You know, I'm an awesome student, but I'm super sucky at seeing my blind spots. And one blind spot I had was that I thought I could keep consuming free information forever. And here's what I learned. There was so much free information out there that it completely overwhelmed me. And also, there are a lot of people with a lot of opinions on the topic of how to grow a business. You've probably found this too. Like maybe you started with one person and you jumped to another person and you jumped to another person. And you know, maybe they all have different takes on it. They have different information. They have different approaches. And it can really be confusing and overwhelming to consume that much free information. Now, if you're listening to them all, like I was, at some point, you're going to feel a little paralyzed. And at some point, I just got to the place where I'm like, I don't know which direction to go because there's so many options. I got really stuck. And if this is true for you, you're either overwhelmed by the sheer amount of all the free stuff you've taken. I mean, it's been valuable to you, but there does come a time when you get overwhelmed by it, or you're confused by which person, which expert to listen to. because everybody has different strategies and opinions and resources, etc. So one of the most valuable things I did for myself was to clean up how much I was consuming. I stopped downloading freebies altogether. I mean, it's so hard though, right? Because everywhere in your Instagram feed or your Facebook feed or your email or whatever you're looking at, even if you're reading a blog, there's always something being advertised to you. It's so hard to stop consuming the freebies because everybody has one. I mean, I have them too, and they're super valuable until they're not. And if you're like me and your freebies are just living on your computer and you're doing nothing with them except feeling guilty, it's time to stop consuming and start taking action. I also stopped following people who didn't speak to doing business in a way that felt good to me. There was one guy I really loved, and he's like a brilliant marketer, but his voice changed and his approach changed, and I just didn't like him anymore. And maybe I changed, right? And that's okay. When I stopped following those people that didn't feel good to me, it allowed me to stop comparing and despairing. Also, I had like 20 varied podcasts on my podcast app, and these were various business experts and productivity experts and marketing experts. And I'm telling you what, I just could not consume it all anymore. It made me feel overwhelmed and paralyzed to open up my podcast and be like, I don't know what to listen to. So now I just follow a few people, and I actually don't listen to as many business podcasts. I actually listen to a lot more like just good stuff for my brain. So find people whose message and strategy resonates with you. And lastly, I hired people to help me because at this point I knew I had consumed a lot. It was really valuable, but now it was worth it to hire somebody to hold my hand, take me through the problems, avoid the pitfalls, and sometimes tell me exactly what to do or say or write so I don't have to figure it out myself. You know, even now, I've had my coach for 2 years, and sometimes I'll say to her, you know, somebody asked me to do this or somebody wants this. I don't know what to say. And she gives me the verbiage, and I can't tell you how much time and energy that saves me. She is worth every single dime I pay her. And doing all of these things cleaned up my time, my energy, and my mind. So how much are you consuming? And of that stuff you're consuming, what's really valuable? What's in alignment with who you are? Now, I understand that it's kind of ironic that I'm saying this because here I am asking you all these questions on a free podcast, and I have lots of free stuff to offer you. But if this isn't valuable to you, then why are you here? So what's in alignment with who you are and what you want to do? After you figure all that stuff out, how much you're consuming, what's valuable, what's in alignment, then you have to ask yourself the hard question, how much are you implementing? Are you doing what a lot of my clients do and sitting on a whole bunch of shit to read and calling it work? And I'm putting air quotes around the word work. Are you taking class after course after workshop and calling it success? How much are you consuming for free? Because yeah, information is good, but implementation is vital. That is where the gold is. So the message here I really want you to take home is, one, yes, put value into the world. Your audience needs it. They crave it because it creates a know, like, and trust factor for them. Cuts through the noise. It develops your relationship. Two, understand that at some point, a percentage of that audience will want to work with you because you've already proven that you're helpful. So when they're ready, they'll pay you. You don't have to feel pushy and yucky and aggressive in marketing yourself. Go ahead and do that, just like I talked about in last week's episode. But three, stop consuming. If you're done with consuming, you'll find you actually take action. And that's where the magic happens. That's where the money is made. That's where the connections are made. Show your value. Show yourself as an expert. Go ahead and make your offers. Remember, this is all a long journey. Remember that your potential clients aren't quite ready to invest money in you, and so they're still downloading the freebies. But if you're ready to take action, it's time to stop downloading the freebies and start taking action. Just keep showing up, put your strategy in place, take focused action, and be consistent. And if you want to learn how to do this stuff in three steps, I'm offering a training. I'm not selling a damn thing. I'm offering it live on August 22nd at 11 a.m. Yes, I am offering this while I'm telling you not to do more free stuff. But if you need to know how to attract your clients more easily and how to stop feeling like you can't take action and you just want people to come into your orbit and how to do that, then this is a training that'll help you. You can register for it at www.jenliddy.com/attract. You'll get notifications of how to join, and I want you to check your spam folder in case I get lost in there. So yes, share your value, keep taking value from people, but be more discerning in who you decide to consume information from and take action, for God's sake. Thanks for listening all the way through. I love that you're here and I really appreciate that you're one of my audience members. I'd love if you want to reach out. You can always go to my website and send me a message there or ask me a question. I will see you next week. Bye. Thanks for joining me today. You can access more free tools and video trainings at www.jenliddy.com/freesources. That's F-R-E-E sources. If you found this podcast helpful, I'd be so grateful if you subscribed and gave a review. And if you have a friend who'd benefit from today's topic, tool, or strategy, please share the Idea Space podcast with her. That way, together, we can help more women achieve their dreams and take action on their ideas. Isn't it time we all were able to get what we want? Join me next week, and remember, right now, all you need to do to make your idea a reality is take the very next step you know how to. Bye!